invite you for this session.
How India will become strong? What is the population? It is about 1.2 billion. That is around 17% of the world's population. According to the census 2017, 62% of the India's population is youth who are energetic and looking for the opportunities. When they are energetic, skilled, innovative, fast, synergies with the opportunities. When we say that, we are in the right way of making India strong. Recently, the two initiatives, particular by the government of India, that is Skill India and Startup India. The mission of Skill India is skill development of youth, make youth employable, and entrepreneurship development. That is for the development of for the youth and for the promotion of entrepreneurship. Programs under Skill India. India Mission of Startup India, promotion of bank finance for the startups, promotion of entrepreneurship, job creation, establishment of innovative ideas. Contribution for the wise ideas. The fact is about both the companies are more focused on the youth of the country, for the skill development and the startups. As much as fresh minds, innovative thoughts, and new things, and they are in a great mood.
My objective for this level is to study the model of an innovative entrepreneur as she steps out into the economy. Women entrepreneurs have been recognized as an important source of economic growth. In today's world, women have gained greater rights in different industries. These are various industries which are promoted by women entrepreneurs, that is, beauty parlors, boutiques, embroidery, handicrafts, and papier mâché. These are some of the qualities of a woman entrepreneur. Accept challenges, ambitious, hardworking, patient, motivated, educator, and intelligent and always problem solving. These are some goals of women entrepreneurship and problems which are faced by women entrepreneurs in India. Shortage of finance, marketing problems, stiff competition in legal formalities. These are some suggestions to overcome these problems faced by women entrepreneurs. These are some of the schemes which are initiated by the government for women entrepreneurs. And at the end, I want to tell about these are some of the examples of successful women entrepreneurs, that is Indrani and Chandra Kocha. And at the end, the conclusion is entrepreneurs serves as the catalyst of economic development of the country. It is one of the last issues for technical exploration. In fact, economic growth is the result of efforts taken by the entrepreneurs.
So first of all, let's just skip the content that is not required. Below the policy, we have a lot of initiatives that is being offered by the Haryana Entrepreneurship Policy. And the policy name is Entrepreneurship and Startup Policy 2017. So in about 15 incentives that is being offered by the system head. Okay, so approximately about 15 policies and initiatives are being offered by the Entrepreneurship and Startup Policy, and I have a detailed study about the incentives. And in my study, I have covered the three areas. First, the study. The second is organization of the study, because we can complete the paper without any organization. And the last one is innovative suggestions about the study. So first of all, these are the initiatives that are being offered by the Entrepreneurship and Startup Policy 2017 in Haryana. These are about 15 of the policies offered, and let's just come to the strengths and weaknesses, and at last the innovative suggestions. So I have the innovative suggestions, and first of all, the policies are innovative. That means we have to offer allowance instead of loans and subsidies, because that will make the entrepreneurs liberated. Another thing is we should offer utilization and generalization incentive. For example, if the person is utilizing and generalizing the skill grant, then he must be supported with at least some fees or some reward. But that is the fund. And another one is insurance. We all know that government is going to insure startup and something like this. So at least government should take new initiatives to set up an insurance policy for the entrepreneurs. And another thing is the provider of mistakes. For example, in the policy, it's only one thing wrong, wrong, wrong. They are making everything for wrong. Please, mind this every year under the cities too. That is whether all the rural areas. So please make innovation centers and IT hubs for other centers too, not just only for wrong. Thank you very much.
technological innovations. It is the extensive organization of an economy for the purpose of manufacturing. There are considerable literature on the factor facilitating industrial modernization and enterprise development. The National Association of Software and Service Companies in 2012 report had stated that 75% of Indian engineering students are not fit for the employment. It is always argued that institutes acquiring technical education have to partner with industries to improve their quality of education, especially in practical component. This will assist in preparing students to be industry ready. Technical institutions and industry which have been operating in separate domains are definitely institutions, and industry which have been operating in separate domains are definitely moving closer to each and create synergy. This will be a win-win situation for industry as well as academic. Industry will be getting trained manpower and their recruitment and training costs will be reduced substantially. On other hand, academic will get sufficient guidelines to enhance the quality of education and making it result-oriented. A productive interface between academic and industry is a critical requirement for the developing country like India. Thank you.
My topic is the economy of entrepreneurship in India. Basically, it is required today time because we know that more than 50% population are engaged in the agriculture sector, and only approximately 40% are growing in GDP. So that's the same time limit for the increasing entrepreneurship in India. So basically, my objective of study is to examine the agro-entrepreneurship environment in India and the commercial skills in India. And basically, this is the sector where we can get a lot of the opportunities like the agriculture, horticulture, and agroforestry, and the sericulture, and other like the biofertilizer, like the site as well. There are new emerging scopes in the agriculture in India, like the agriculture and agri-clinics, and rubber development tools. They are also providing to get a lot of entrepreneurship in India. So finally, I am moving to my this is actually budget 2018-19. Government of India has also allocated lots of funds in developing for the agriculture sector, and he allocated 470 infrastructure marketing committees for enhancement. There are a lot of challenges here. This time only for the development of agri business, and the government of India has a lot of schemes that are planning for the improving the agriculture in this area. So we have to be also planning. Need for the time for the controlling my piece is that we have also become a agro-entrepreneurship in India. We can also create a balance in environment. Thank you very much.
Entrepreneurship in rural India. Empowering rural women through games of employment will bring cost, respect, and recognition to their valuable contribution in value generation and labor. Women in rural India who contribute in various agro and agro-related activities have tremendous potential and will to work and earn for supplementary family.